If you work remote like me, you will probably know that there are those days when you just can't get your work done. Maybe you lack concentration or there are simply too many distractions in your home office. In this case, what works for me is just switching up the environment for a while. For example, a nice cozy coffee shop, a co-working space, or even the library will help me to get back into the zone and finish that huge pile of boring tasks. And what do we need in that case? Of course, a glorious EDC that fits all your needs and is just like that one friend that is always there for you. So, let's talk about mine. When it comes to wallets, I want something that is as compact as possible, but still provides enough space to fit my cards, cash, and sometimes some emergency coins. My pick for this year is the Secret Card Slate, which protects all my 6 cards with an RFID card protector that is also removable, so I can carry it around on its own if I don't need any cash for the day. If I need cash, however, there's 2 options. The first is just putting bills and also coins inside of the case, and the second is the money band around the casing, which also can hold up a few bills for quick access. Since you can disassemble the case, it is also possible to configure your wallet as you want. Secret offers quite a few color options that you can choose from and then build up your own color combinations. Pretty dope in my opinion, and they have some really nice designs and also some special editions on their website. Heading over to the power bank, I need something that is not too bulky but just has enough juice for powering all my devices. My pick here is the Anker Nano with 10k milliamp hours. It features this small display which tells you how many battery percentage you have left by pressing the top button, and also gives you a hours left to you when charging the devices. It has 2 USB-C and 1 USB-A port, with 1 USB-A port being located at the top, featuring this cable that also functions as a nice little handle. It charges rather quick via 30 watt fast charge, and you can charge up to 3 devices at the same time. The only thing that I'm not so sure about is the color though. I thought I might switch it up a little bit and get a power bank that is not black, but in the end I consider this a mistake, but at least I tried something different, right? You of course can pick up a black version as well, or either one of the other colors that Anker has to offer. With the power bank out of the way, let's talk about my earbuds. And these are important, because if you work from a noisy coffee shop, for example, you will be so grateful having a good pair of noise cancelling earbuds or even headphones. My choice are the Jabra Elite 8 Active. They are dustproof and also waterproof, so perfectly fine if you go to the gym or maybe even the beach. The battery life is enough in my opinion and can hold up to 14 hours if the ANC is turned off, and I think about 8 hours with the active noise cancellation on. What I really like is this soft rubber finish on the outside of the earbuds. It just feels so good to the touch, and also with the 6 built-in microphones you will get a pretty decent audio when taking phone calls, for example. So overall, a great product for the price. I can highly recommend these if you are currently looking for a new pair of earbuds. Consider checking them out. When it comes to data transfer or cables, so to say, I like some products that have multi-use, so I can be as minimal as possible on the go. I usually carry one slightly larger cable if I want to use the device when charging it from my backpack, for example, and one small cable just in addition, and also when I need to charge multiple devices at the same time. My go-to choices here are first the InCharge XL, which comes in a length of 2 meters, features a rubber case, and also this rugged braiding. The cool thing here is you can swap the USB type by just pulling on the connector. It is also fully made out of metal, and the cables hold together via a strong magnet. Plus, you will have this nice protective cover that slides over the ports. As the second cable, I got the Van Malen All-Roundo. It is a small coiled cable that comes in this cute little case and has different adapters for USB-C, Lightning, and also micro USB. It's strange, but it just feels so powerful to be able to charge any device I own with just this small of a cable, so very nice. That said, I sometimes carry one more multi-use cable or gadget around that has also a SD card reader. I have planned another video for my top desk accessories that will feature this product, so keep an eye out for next week. Anyway, let's talk about my choice for tech organization. I own a lot of pouches, but my go-to is easily the tech bag from Bellroy in this beautiful Patty Mills edition. Be it the graphics on the inside or the little details like the colored zipper dongles are just perfect in my opinion. And it doesn't just look great, it also feels great and offers very thoughtful storage options. Like these big pouches here on the side with this elastic material that kind of wraps around your gear. Also this back compartment that closes via a strong magnet and has this slim extra storage, or here these cable and pencil straps. All my gear fits perfectly and I'm so in love with the inside graphics and the overall quality that Bellroy offers. The only thing that I would change is probably the outer material. It looks kind of wrinkly and I would prefer to be a bit smoother, but that's just complaining at a very high level. That said, I think this bag is one of the best, if not the best tech bag that is currently on the market, and Bellroy delivers as usual. With that out of the way, let's talk about another very important item, a trusty water bottle. And no, I'm not gonna make a big speech here about the importance of drinking enough water during the day, but I keep realizing how important it is for me to drink enough because it makes me feel much more awake and more productive and also less hungry, saving me a few unnecessary calories that I wouldn't actually need. That said, my choice here is the Water Drop All-Purpose Ultralight, a stainless steel water bottle that has different lids which you can choose from depending on your needs. I have the swing lid that features this nice hefty handle and closes by rotating the knob. And what I really like about it, despite the design of course, is the big opening on the bottle itself that makes cleaning so much easier. And also the 1.2 liter volume is just perfect for me. I carry this around the whole time and it always remembers me to drink enough. So definitely an item that shouldn't miss in any EDC if you would ask me. Well, next up, the item that holds my messy life together, a notebook or daily planner. My go-to choice is actually a daily planner from Amazon Basics that has different sections for weekly planning, daily planning, and also a calendar view. But most of the time I only use the daily planner. It lets you define the most important tasks for today, also your main goal and schedule. And at the bottom you also have some fields for reflecting, what worked well this day, and on what topics you could improve, for example. I tend to plan my days in the morning. I will block about 15 minutes and then think about the tasks I have to finish during the day and also define a main goal. In addition, I do also document my schedule for my morning routine and night routine, plus every meeting I will have throughout the day. And if it somehow happens that I don't check all the boxes on the tasks, I just bring them over to the next day and try to finish them first. Sometimes I carry a small notebook in addition. My choice here are the field notes that I think everyone at this point knows. They are just so convenient if you need something small and rugged, so a great addition, but also very expensive for the small amount of pages you get. That said, you might be wondering why I don't use any of those fancy apps for note-taking or planning, and the answer is actually pretty easy. I just look at so many displays during the day, so it's a welcoming change to disconnect from the digital world for a while, and also I feel like I can remember stuff way easier when I write them down on physical, on real paper. Lastly, I often grab some sort of fidget toy that helps me relaxing in stressful meetings or maybe when thinking through a difficult problem. Right now I like the PopSocket Pop Puck because it is also a keychain and it has these magnetic pucks that I like to slide around or even try flip and trick shots with it, though I'm not really good at it. A small addition, but it keeps things a little bit more fun in my opinion. If you are looking for a new mouse right now, consider checking out my video about the Razer ProClick. Here, I use this mouse on a daily and it is a very nice addition to my setup. And if you enjoyed the content, consider subscribing and also boop the like button. That always helps me to grow the channel and produce better and overall more content for you guys. Regardless, Thanks for hanging out today, and I see you next week.